So without delay, without any further delay, let me invite the second speaker. That is Professor Dhamini, who is a director in the VHS Party of London, talked about the Co-Mafia and control in Sri Lanka. He is honorary clinical professor in surgery for the Faculty of Medicine, General Sir John Vakarawa Jukanik University, and senior consultant surgeon at the Sri Jadavpur General Hospital. He has served the Council of the College of Surgeons for 14 years and was elected as the president in 2001. His special surgery interests are in trauma care, especially oral surgery, gastrointestinal surgery, surgery for breast, thyroid, hernia, and laparoscopic surgery.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, for the kind words of introduction. I must also thank the organizers for inviting me to make a presentation at this important meeting of the KGU. My presentation today is also on a non-communicable disease, but it's not a medical non-communicable disease. It's a surgical non-communicable disease called trauma. And the title of my lecture is Trauma Care and Control in Sri Lanka, the Need for Education and Research. As we all know, trauma is a major cause of death and disability throughout the world. It is called the neglected killer or the neglected stepchild of modern medicine, because the money that is spent for trauma care and control is much less than the money spent for other conditions like ischemic heart disease, stroke, hypertension, diabetes, HIV, so surgeons are always forgotten. But it's a very important topic, and I will show you why it is important in Sri Lanka. In USA, it is the leading cause of death in the first 4 decades of life, and the number of deaths according to the latest figures in US amount to 480,000 per year, and the incidence is 2.3 million cases per year, and see the cost. Over $406 billion is spent in US for trauma care and control and prevention. Now, if we go to analyze trauma care and control in the same manner as in US, we do not have all this data. But something that is known is, in Sri Lanka, the leading cause of hospital admissions since 1995 is trauma. And I will show you some figures that is available. And the hospital deaths, if you look at the Ministry of Health bulletin, it is the number 11 cause of hospital deaths in Sri Lanka, the commonest cause being ischemic heart disease. And these are the types of trauma that we see in Sri Lanka. We have so many different types of trauma, and we can see all these types every day in our hospitals throughout the length and breadth of this nation. Fortunately, we don't see any more war injuries, but we see people being shot in different places of our country. During the time of the war, we had so many different types of injuries, like landmine injuries, anti-personnel mine injuries, bomb blasts. But today we see other injuries, like burns, still we see that. We see staff injuries. We see people being shot. We see road traffic accidents. We see agricultural accidents. We see people falling from heights and coming to hospitals with head injuries, spinal injuries, and that type of problem. So in this lecture, I would like to highlight some of these important aspects about trauma. Firstly, the incidence and causes of trauma in Sri Lanka, the impact of trauma on society, the trauma care services that are available in Sri Lanka at present, and the recommendations for care and control, the need for research, and also the need for prevention of these terrible problems in Sri Lanka. Now, if you want to, anyone wants to study the problem of trauma in Sri Lanka, and there's a problem initially at the beginning of your, if you want to start some research, first of all, there is a lack of a central data collection unit for trauma, and the available data may be incomplete and may not be reliable. So if you want to study, I have been studying this problem for over 10 years, and I have to get data from many, many places. First of all, the annual health bulletin of the Ministry of Health, but that is not available for about 2 or 3 years after the current year. then we have to go to the police department to get statistics about road traffic accidents. So you have to know the DIG in charge of traffic, otherwise you can't get statistics. Then I have to go to the Department of Census and Statistics. There I have to know the director of the department, otherwise I can't enter that place. Then I go to the epidemiology unit. They say I have no data on trauma. Then I go to the medical statistician. Then I go to hospital's accident service and get data from different places and my own data. And all this data, if you analyze over the years, it will show that there is significant morbidity, mortality and increase in the number of patients being injured. Now if you look at these figures from 1991 to 2008, in 1991 it was ranked as number 3, in 2008 it became number 1. See the number of admissions that have gone up. The percentage of admissions have gone up. And total number of admissions nearly 5 million per year. Now if you look at the data, the latest data available, 2012, it has gone up to over 800,000 admissions for trauma in Sri Lanka, accounting for 17% of all admissions and 3.7% of all deaths. So these are big numbers. And most of these patients are treated in government hospitals and the country has to spend. And we do not know how much of the money that is available in our country is spent for this type of problem. Not only hospital care, rehabilitation, compensation, insurance, loss of productivity, all those must be calculated when you go into the cost. Now what are the different types? We see road traffic accidents, occupational accidents, burn injuries, war injuries we do not see anymore, but there is shooting. Because there are enough weapons available throughout the length and breadth of this country. Home accidents, falls, assaults, thefts, all these cases we see. Road traffic accidents, I do not have to mention about road traffic accidents. We have eliminated terrorism in our country, but there is terrorism on the highway. There is terrorism on the highway today. You can see this. The number of people dying on a highway, every day 6 people are dying. And that is more than the number of people dying of dengue fever. And we are only worried about dengue, every day dengue. But no one is talking about trauma. See the amount of people dying. Now road traffic accident data, you can see a number increasing. From 2010 to 2012, the number has gone up. The fatal accidents, 2,370, number of deaths, 2,444. That means 6 deaths per day. Now road traffic accident, the number injured, also has gone up from 2002 to 2012, and most of them are in the young age group, 21 to 55 age group. 6 people are dying on our roads every day, and every day there are 135 accidents in our country. Now what are the vehicles involved? The commonest vehicle involved is the motorcycle, followed by the trishaw, motor car, private bus, van and the lorry. And private buses are mostly from belonging to politicians and policemen. Most of the victims who are dead are pedestrians. I think that number will go down because now we have payments. Motorcyclists, passengers, cyclists, drivers, in that order. But most of them are pedestrians. Now I get on to another important place in our country, the accident service. The number of people treated at accident service, over 100,000. The number of admissions, over 37,000. Transfer from other hospitals, over 8,000. That means that most of the other hospitals do not have proper facilities for trauma care. The number of deaths at accident service, nearly 200. Number of patients with burn injuries, 490. And most of these patients are coming after road traffic accidents. And most of them are preventable. Occupational accidents, home accidents and assaults. And you can see those figures. Comparing 2012 and 2013, all the numbers have gone up except there is a very marginal reduction in the number of road traffic accident victims and burn victims. But everything has gone up, including the number of people coming after alcoholic intoxication. The number of people going to the neurotrauma center with head injuries have gone up. The number of patients with spinal injuries, causing permanent disability has gone up.